So our headliner is Scott Wise, president and CEO of Pots and Pans Productions. I'm just checking that just one more time to make sure it's not auto-advancing. All right, is the CEO of Pots and Pans Productions, the parent management company for Scotty's Brewhouse and Three Wise Men Brewing Company. Scotty, as is dubbed by his late grandfather, is a family man. Married to his wife, Amy, for 15 years, their family includes four children. He's an avid exercise enthusiast. Scott also enjoys attending sporting events, travel, reading, and always striving to better himself. Wise's restaurants represent a focus on high quality food, craft beer, and exceptional service, and the exciting sports-minded yet family-friendly atmosphere. Scotty is well known as a community philanthropist, consistently committing his time, effort, along with his monetary and food donations to causes in every city in which his restaurants reside. He's a firm believer in reaching back and offering a hand whenever and wherever one is needed. Scotty also knows in life, just as in his restaurants, it takes everyone working together to be successful. Just a selection of Scotty's business accomplishments include the following: Indiana Restaurant Association Board Director, West Point Financial's Blue Chip Award winner, Indiana Business Journal 40 Under 40 Award winner, Dad Inc.'s Father of the Year of 2010, 2011 TechPoint Mural Award of Innovative Use of Technology and New Media Excellence winner, Central Indiana Junior Achievement, Best and Brightest Top 10 nominee of 2011. Please give me a hand and help me invite Scott to the stage.
Technology. If you had one shot or one opportunity.
Love that song. So as my wife and four children can attest, I rarely make it 10 minutes. So that's the sex joke. They don't get any better, so laugh now. Thank you guys for attending tonight and braving the polar vortex, or what we used to call winter. But seriously, I'm honored to speak with you tonight. Thanks, Chris. I appreciate it. So Scott Michael Wise, born to either get his ass kicked on the playground or be a CEO. And I think both those things happened. Several years later, I was blessed to be able to open a lot of restaurants. And I pause not because I don't know what I want to say, because I get, someone should hit the pause button when I cry, because I'm a crier and I shouldn't get penalized for time, but I'm blessed because I've got a good team around me. I'm one guy and I get my name put on the restaurants and I get a lot of credit, a lot of publicity for something that people like the guy that's sitting right over here that helped get here an hour early to help set this thing up, Bruce McLean. And I'm blessed because they make me who I am. Now, what this doesn't show you in 18 years of growth with this restaurant concept is the recession. And my second restaurant when I was 24 and I lost $1 million and I closed the place 3 years later. What you don't see are the cracks in the walls, right? You get to see all the positive spin in the stories, and that's good. I want you to see that stuff. I want you to love my restaurant for what it is. But I'm here tonight to tell you that I'm not ashamed of those things. Those things make me who I am. See, I think that we in life, we challenge things. We ask God why, we ask ourselves, why is this happening to me? What is this divorce? What is this job loss? What is this recession? And those things are your defining character moments. See, I take those things and I am like you, I get pissed and I get sad and I cry. But I also take those things and I learn from them. And I think that is the true test of your character, right? Of a man and a woman, when times are not good, how do you react? Do you help people across the street when people aren't looking? That's who you are. That's who I try to be, is a good person. So 3 years ago, I got a brain infection. It's called viral encephalitis. And I'm almost positive I didn't get in college, but I can't guarantee it. I can't guarantee it. My doctor promised me that didn't come from anything down here. As I told you, it's 10 minutes max, so it didn't come from there. So what happened is they can't tell me what happened. They can't tell me why I got it or how I got it, but what I believe is that God was trying to talk to me a few years earlier and trying to tell me to slow down and appreciate life and appreciate your wife and your children. and I wasn't listening, and I was growing, and I was moving, and I was fast with the restaurant. And I got this, and I was in the ambulance at 2 in the morning going to Community North, and I saw the lights, and I'm a member of Northview Church up in Carmel, love my church, and I had promised myself I was going to get baptized for a long time, for probably a year, and I'd gotten baptized as a kid, and I went through church, and it just wasn't anything to me, it didn't mean anything to me, and then I found Northview, and I said I was going to get baptized, and then I opened a restaurant, and then this happened, and then I had to do this, and I didn't, and then I saw red and blue lights, and I'm laying there, and I'm asking myself, who's gonna help my wife? Who's gonna walk my daughter down the aisle? Who's gonna teach my son how to shave? And I didn't get baptized. And I'm not here to pump church on anybody. I don't think that's fair to anybody. I think you everyone should do what's right to them. But for me, and when I came out of that seizure, and when I came back to reality 3 days later, I got baptized a month later after I got out of the hospital, and it was a life-altering event for me, and it changed me. It changed who I wanted to be as a person with my wife, with my family, with my parents, with my sisters, but it did it with my business as well, and it did some amazing things. It made me realize that I'm not going to be the best restaurateur. Even though Chris can sit up here and tell you all these accolades that don't mean really anything. They're on paper, and I do what I do because you guys do what you do, right? You do what you do because you love what you do. You have a passion for it. And if you don't, then you're in the wrong place. You don't have the right job yet or you're not fulfilling what you're supposed to do in life. I love what I do. But I love those five people even more. And it made me realize that work should end at a reasonable time. And we're all connected, right? I found myself at home with my son while he's trying to read to me, and I'm checking my email, or I'm checking Twitter, or something stupid that I shouldn't be doing. And I still have lapses. I still am addicted to my iPhone, like many of you. But I had an awakening, and it really helped, and I get a great newsletter for any dads in the room called All Pro Dads that every morning I read it, and it's kind of just, you got to get recentered, right? It helps me get recentered with what I want to do. So I knew that I would rather be a great father than the best restaurateur in town. I'm not saying that I'm not going to bust my ass and try hard and make you all happy. I'm still wondering why I didn't host the event, but we'll talk about that later. I'm just kidding. This is a great room. We don't have this room. But what it did was, I never had a mission statement in my company for 17 years because I thought it was bullshit. I thought it was something you were supposed to do if you were a corporation, and I'm going to fight the man, right? I'm becoming this thing that I always hated, that I didn't want to be a chain restaurant. Now what? We have got like 12 locations, and you become what you don't want to be. So I was fighting this mission statement thing forever, and I thought, finally, after I went through what I went through, I said, I'm going to do something that means something to me and to my team. And so what I did is I created a lot of things from a book that I love called Everything I Need to Learn, I Learned in Kindergarten. And it's the things that we should know that kids today don't, for some reason, know. Like, say please and thank you and open the door for somebody. And after you flush the toilet, wash your damn hands. They do at my restaurant, by the way. But I came up with this vision statement, and this is the back of a card that they carry in their wallets and their purses. And next time you're at the restaurant, ask them if they have it, and I hope to God they're carrying it like they're supposed to. And on the front of the card, it says, I'm going to go to work, and I'm going to make blank proud today. And I told them, if they think I'm a dick and they don't like working for me, then go to work and make yourself proud. Or fill in the blank with whatever you want it to be, your mom, your parents, your kids. Make somebody proud. And then do these things. Be passionate about something. Make a difference in our world. And the one that stands out to me the most, and the thing that I try to do with them, is that bottom line. Every 90 days, do something good in your world, in your community. As I joke around a lot, I say, I mean, the world has gotten so angry. And I know social media is partly to blame, but damn, Twitter and Yelp need a hug sometimes, don't they? I mean, they are just so mad. I mean, I get it. Sometimes the food is cold, but we're trying. I promise we don't care. So What I try to do with my people is, and what I've felt, what I've been blessed with in my life with this restaurant concept, is not just serving burgers and beer and fries and pizza and fried pickles, which are all delicious, but my job is, I feel like I've got the opportunity to take 900 employees and make them better people in our world. And if I can touch them in some way, affect them so that when they leave, someday down the road, they think back and think, man, Scott was great. He had events at his house, and he invited us all over. And he asked our kids to dress up, and he got fire engines to let them walk behind and collect candy. Because he did things at his downtown restaurant for the fourth year in a row by giving back to the homeless. I want to make a mark because I want to reach back and give a hand to the people that need a lift up. I feel like that's what God has given me in my life, is a soapbox to stand on. And occasionally, for those that follow me know, I tweet some dumb shit. But I think that I also do some good things for our world and our community. And I'm going to continue to do that because I believe that's what I've been blessed and given to do. And I don't know if it's apropos to leave a slide like this after we've lost Robin Williams, a great comedian and actor, but this is something I believe in. And I think that it's so easy to say, but it's you almost have to experience seeing those red and blue lights in an ambulance. And maybe you don't. Maybe you can leave tonight and leave here and say, you know what? I'm going to hug my wife or husband when I get home. Or I'm going to spend a few extra minutes with my kids and tell them I love them and tell them good job at school today. Because it just takes one to turn these things around. So thank you for having me. I appreciate it. I'm very honored to speak with you. Don't forget to visit Scotty sometime. Not tonight, but sometime. Thank you.
Look. If you had...
Give a round of applause, man.